All right, let's revise the index once more time so that you will have little more comfort over it. So we are into which act? Income Tax Act 1961. Income tax is divided into chapters and chapters are divided into sections. We started writing sections. All right, we have written index through sections. So section 1. Section 1 talks about scope, extent, title and applicability. What is section 1? Scope, extent, title and applicability. Section 2, definitions. All right. Section 3, previous year. Section 4, charging section, basis of charge or charging section. Section 5, scope of total income. Section 6, residential status. Section 7, income deemed to be received in India. Section 8, dividend income. Section 9, income deemed to be accrued in India. Section 10, exempt income. Again, I'm going from section 1 because nobody is talking to me. All right, section 1, scope, extent, title and applicability. Section 2, definition. Section 3, previous year. Section 4, basis of charge. Okay, or charging section, anything that you are comfortable. Okay, section 5, scope of total income. Section 6, residential status. Section 7, income deemed to be received in India. Alright. Section 8, dividend income. Section 9, income deemed to accrue in India. Section 10, exempt income. Section 11, 12, 13, exempt assessees. Section 14A, guarding section. Section 14, heads of income. It is divided into 5 heads. First head, section 15 to 17, income from salary. Section 22 to section 27, income from house property. Section 28 to 44, DB. Alright, or section 28 to 44. Section 28 to 44, PGBP, profits and gains from business or profession. Alright, section 45 to 55A, capital gain. Section 56 to 59, income from other sources. All right, section 60 to 65, clubbing of income. Section 68, 69, 69A, 69B, 69C, 69D, aggregation of income, black money and all. All right, section 70 to 80, set off and carry forward of losses. All right, then section 87A, rebate. All right, I forgot to mention one series, I guess. Section 80, can you put that series there? Okay, unfortunately, I don't know why. I did not mention about section 80C to section 80U. Somewhere you put there on top, bottom, anywhere you can put section 80. A very important series, I don't know how I have left it. Section 80C to 80U, this is chapter 6A deduction from GTI. GTI means gross total income, that I will teach you later on. 80C to 80U, chapter 6A, deduction from GTI. 6A we always write Roman, whenever we refer chapter we write chapter 6A. Okay. Section 80C to section 80U, chapter 6A deductions, okay, from GTI. GTI means gross total income. Yes, can I go ahead?
Yes.
All right, so 80C to 80U, chapter 6A deduction. Then 87A, rebate. All right, rebate of 2500, discount. Section 89, relief under salary. Section 90, 90A, 91, DTAA, double taxation avoidance agreement. All right, then we have started with section 110 to 115. 110, 94 bond washing transactions. Okay, 110 to 115 special rates of tax. 116 to 138 powers of income tax authorities. All right, 139 filing of return of income. All right, section 140 verification of return of income. Section 140A self-assessment tax. Then section 141 to section 160 assessment procedures. And then we are having section 190 to 206AA tax deducted at source. Then we are having section 206C, Alright, tax collected at source. Then we are having section 207 to 219. Advance tax. One more time we will do. Okay, we are into which act? Income Tax Act 1961. It is divided into chapters and chapter into sections. Alright, first section. Section 1. Alright, section 1. Scope, extent, title and applicability. Section 2. Definition. Section 3. Previous year. Section 4. Basis of charge. Alright, section 5. Scope of total income. Section 6. Residential status. Section 7. Income deemed to be received in India. 8. Dividend income. 9. Income deemed to be accrued in India. Section 10. Exempt income. 11, 12, 13. Exempt SEC. 14A. Guarding section. 14. Heads of income. 15 to 17. Income from salary. 22 to 28. Income from 27. Income from house property. 28 to 44 DB. Profits and gains from business or profession. Very good. Then 45 to 55A. Capital gain. 56 to 59. Income from other sources. 60 to 65. Clubbing of income. 68, 69, 69A, 69B, 69C, 69D. Aggregation of income. Okay, section 70 to section 80. Set off and carry forward of losses. Alright, section 80C to 80U. Chapter 6A, deductions from GTI. Alright, then 87A. Rebate. Section 89, relief under salary. Section 90, 90A, 91, DTAA. Alright, double taxation avoidance agreement. Then we are having section 94, bond washing transaction. Then we are having section 110 to 115, special rates of tax. Very good. Then we are having 116 to 138, powers of income tax authorities. We are having section 139, filing of ROI. Alright, then we are having 140, verification of ROI. We are having 140A, self-assessment tax. We are having 141 to 160, assessment procedure. Alright, then we are having 190 to 206 AA, TDS, tax deducted at source. Then we are having section 206C, tax collected at source. 207 to 219, advanced tax. You understood? Okay, very fast. Section 1, scope, extent, title and applicable. 2, definition. 3, previous year. 4, charging section. Alright, 5th, scope of total income. 6, residential status. 7, received in India. Okay, 8, dividend income. Then income deemed to be accrued in India. Section 10, exempt income. 11, 12, 13, exempt SEC. 14A, guarding section. 14, heads of income. Alright, 15 to 17, income from salary. 22 to 27, income from house property. 28 to 44 DB, profits or gains, and gains from business or profession. 45 to 55A, capital gain. 56 to 59, income from other sources. Alright, 60 to 65, clubbing of income. 68, 69, 69A, B, C, D, aggregation of income. 70 to 80, set off and carry forward of losses. 80C to 80U. 6A, deduction from GTI, gross total income. Alright, then we are having 87A, rebate under section 87A, that is 2500. Then we are having section 89, relief under salary. 90, 90A, 91, DTAA. Alright, double taxation avoidance agreement. Then we are having 94, bond washing transaction. Then we are having 110 to 115, special rate of tax. 116 to 138, powers of income tax authorities. Alright, then 139, filing of ROI. 140, verification of ROI. 141, 140A, self-assessment tax. 141 to 160, assessment procedure. Then we are having 190 to 206 AA, tax deducted at source. Section 206C, tax collected at source. Section 207 to 219, advanced tax. Okay, this is 100 marks. This is 100 marks syllabus. Let's start with the first section of understanding chapter 1, basic concept. Give the heading concept 1. Chapter 1, basic concept, concept 1, basis of charge, section 4 I am teaching. Allow me to teach first and then you write. Total income. Now please understand one thing. In income tax, tax is not on any random income. Okay? So there are a lot of income that you will be earning in future. Tax is only on total income. Hello? Yes. So your understanding and income tax understanding differs. Alright? In your understanding, it might be income. But from income tax perspective, it might not be income. In your understanding, it might not be income. But from income tax understanding, it might be a income. So your understanding and their understanding differs. This is the law one. Alright? So income tax says tax is not on income. It is on total income. Okay? So sir, can you elaborate it? Yes. For that, allow me to put concept 2 also on my board. Okay? Concept 2, I will be talking about total income. And then we have to divide income in two parts, okay? Please understand, two parts. There are two types of income that we have in income tax. Income forms part of total income, okay? Income forms part of total income. And then we are having incomes which do not forms part of total income. So there are income which forms part of total income, taxable or not taxable? Incomes which forms part of total income, taxable or not taxable? Taxable, because my charge is on total income. If income becomes total income, it is taxable. But there are incomes which do not form part of. So taxable or not taxable? Not taxable. Therefore, these incomes are given in section 5, which is known as scope of total income. Okay? And these incomes are given in section 10, which is known as exempt income. Okay? So section 5 is known as scope of total income, whereas section 10 knows as exempt incomes. Okay, so which is taxable, which is not taxable? Obviously this is taxable and that is not. Exempt means it is not taxable. Okay, you can put one more point if you want. This is taxable income, those are not taxable income, or exempt income, similar language is this. Okay, so you understand there are two types of income we have. Income which are taxable and income which are not taxable. So agriculture income belongs to section 10. Taxable or not taxable? Not taxable. Dividend from Indian company belongs to section 1030 for up to 10 lakh. There is a limit now, up to 10 lakh. So up to 10 lakh it is not taxable. So after 10 lakh, then excess amount will form part of total income. So if you want 12 lakh rupee dividend, 10 lakh rupees not taxable, but 2 lakh rupees will become taxable. You understand? So some incomes are unlimited exempt and some incomes are limited exempt. But limited and unlimited both are there in section 10. Alright? So I'll be teaching lot of incomes which forms part of total income and which does not form part of total income. This is how we have to discuss. These sections are chapters in themselves. Okay? Section 5 is the one chapter and section 10 is another chapters. Here just I wanted to mention that there are two types of incomes. Incomes which form part of total income and incomes which does not form part of total income. Am I clear? Forms part of total income, taxable in income tax, does not form part of total income, not taxable in income tax. Am I clear about this much? Total income. Okay. Earned by a person. It has to be earned by person. Alright. It has to be earned by person. So second point, like I would like to teach you. From this I taught you what is total income. From this I would like to teach you what is person. Okay. So income tax is applicable to person. That is my concept 3. Okay. Income tax is applicable to person. Okay. And definition of person is given under section. Okay. Person means. No, sorry. Person definition is not means. I was trying to say is not means definition. It is. Person includes definition. Person includes. Okay, that means the definition is not exhaustive. The definition is inclusive in nature. And that is given under section 231. Section 2 is about definition. 31 is my clause. So clause 31 of section 2 of Income Tax Act 1961 defines person includes. Alright. Because if they give me definition of means, this is person means, okay, this is what person means. Then if you prove one thing, that I am not person, then law will not become applicable to you. Yes. You just have to prove one thing, I am not person. According to income tax, I am not person. This law is applicable to person. If you prove this thing that you are not a person, then you don't have to pay tax. So then who is there in person? So obviously, when this organization of commerce started, okay, when this business evolution happened in human life, in human race, so only one member from a family used to do business or used to earn money. Only one member, okay? Probably your father. Alright. So only one member used to earn and other members used to enjoy the life. They will do some cultivation and other things in house. But outside the house, only one person will go and earn. And therefore, the first form of business that we had is kind of proprietorship business or individual business. Okay? Proprietorship business or individual business. So person obviously includes individual. Okay? So there are persons which are known as individual. You also fall in this category. Individual. Alright. So what are the subcategories of individual, sir? So in individual, we are having minor, major. Okay. Minor, major. Minor means up to which age?
18.
18. After 18, you becomes major. Then you become senior citizen. After? 60 years. And then there is one class in income tax which is having 80 years. Super senior citizens. Alright. Very senior citizens. So minor, major, senior citizens. Minor, major or citizens, then super the senior citizen after 60 and super senior citizen after 80. This is one category. Then there is a male, female.
Yes.
Alright, male, female, others, whatever you can say. Alright. So earlier there was a discrimination in income tax. Male was having different limits, female was having different limit, but that discrimination is eliminated now. No bhedbhav, no discrimination. Alright. Now both are treated same in law. Yes. Okay. So individuals have this type of types. Then when demand of business got increased, okay, requirement of people involved in the business got increased, what they started doing? Organization of commerce pada hai? OC? Okay, after proprietorship, which forms came? HUF came, alright, because people from family also got involved. Now wife also started assisting, okay, children also started getting involved in the family business. And that particular business was known as HUF. Hindu undivided family. Now I have no intention to teach you what is HUF. Okay, that was your responsibility in 11th standard or 12th standard somewhere. Okay, but still some ideology of what is HUF. So it is known as Hindu undivided family because whole family gets involved into the business or income, or they get right in the property. All right. In India, we are having two Hindu schools which are having two different methods of following or implementing the law. One is Mitakshara law. Another is Deva Bhaga, Daya Bhaga, something like this. Okay, Daya Bhaga law. Alright, Mitakshara law and Daya Bhaga law. Whole India follows Mitakshara law, whereas Assam and West Bengal, somewhere there, they follow Daya Bhaga law. Major difference between these two laws is, in this law, Mitakshara law, by birth you become member in the properties. Alright, and there in Daya Bhaga law, unless and until senior most members doesn't die, so senior most member has to die. So if grandfather is there, he must die, then only second generation can become owner in the properties. All right so here you by birth you become, there you become only if somebody dies. All right so something like this is there. Apart from that, Mitakshara law is male dominated law, so male members in a family, they are more dominated. And in Assam and West Bengal, female dominance is more than male dominance. So that powers are also like that. So some difference are there. For us, we are indifferent whether it is Mitakshara or whether it is Daya Bhaga. For each HUF means HUF. If HUF is earning income, then we will tax it as HUF. Okay. Then after HUF, requirement of business got increased. Okay. More capital were required. More people were required. So what has happened? What was the next version of business organization came?
Partnership
firm. Now there are two types of firms. Come on, can you tell me two types of firms? Achha, firms get registered in which act?
32.
Partnership Firms Act 1932. Excellent, excellent. Okay. Here in income tax, firms includes LLP also. Anybody know? LLP Act? LLP Act? Hello? LLP Act 2008. So if you form a partnership, so it is Partnership Act 1932. And if you want to incorporate LLP, I must say incorporate because it happens through ROC, Register of Company. So that, then LLP Act 2008. So here LLP and firms are the same thing. Okay, there is no distinction between firm and LLP. Both are firms. Okay, but sometimes you call proprietorship firm also. Proprietorship firm is already covered under individual. It doesn't have separate entity. A proprietorship doesn't have separate entity concept. Individual is the owner, but partnership firm is having separate entity. Firm is different, partners are different for us. Okay. There are two types of firms.
No.
There are two types of partnership firms. You have discussed these types of partnership firm in OC. One is this, another one. Private. What is unlimited and limited? Anything. Registered and unregistered. There can be a registered partnership firm and unregistered partnership firm. Partnership firm registered under Partnership Act is registered. Partnership firm which is not registered in India is not firm for us. For us, it's not a partnership firm. For us, it is AOP BOI. Okay. For us, it is AOP or BOI. You just have to write this only AOP or BOI. This, I am not saying that it has to be unregistered, but it can be registered or it can be unregistered. Okay. It can be AOP BOI. Can, this has to be registered. There is no choice. This has to be registered. But this can be registered or unregistered. So three friends started business, doing business together, and they have not executed partnership deed. So what do we call them in OC? We call them unregistered partnership firm. In income tax, we call them AOP BOI. Association of persons or body of individuals. Joint venture accounting people have done?
Yes.
Two companies coming together. So the third company is association of person. Okay. So Riksha Chalak Union. Labor union, all right, this union, that union, college union, many unions you people have seen. That is body of individual. Your gym, okay, gym where you go for workouts, you might have seen, okay, there you have to become member, all right. That means that body is by the member, for the member, and that body is known as body of individual. So this is how it goes. It might be registered, it may not be. Alright, so there are chances. May be registered, may not be registered. But this is how it goes. Am I clear? Then one more doubt. My Kerala student usually ask me, sir, if Hindu people runs family business, then that is known as Hindu undivided family. What about Christians family running business? Family business. Or what about Muslim families running business together? What about Jain families running business together? What about Sikh families running business together? You understand?
Yes.
So what do we call to their family business? Because this is only exclusively applicable to Hindu undivided family. So what about other families who are doing business together? So obviously they come under which category? Body of individual. Because they are body and there are a lot of individuals involved into it. So it is known as body of individual, which might be registered or unregistered. Then demand of business got increased, more capital, more finance, more people. You tell me, what happened then? What came?
Cooperative society
is not a thing. That is same. Joint stock company. All right, then what came in this existence?
1956.
Ah, somebody tell him 1956 is deleted and 2013 has come so many years back. Now 2018 amended act also came.
Yeah.
Ah, 1956. दादाजी है क्या 25-30 साल से तो नहीं पढ़ रहा कंपनी आ गया क्या मेरा परक्यूजेट आ चुका है कंपनी अच्छा कंपनी बहुत सारे टाइप की होती है ऑलराइट लेकिन कोई भी टाइप की कंपनी होने दो एनी टाइप हियर कंपनी इज कंपनी ओके बाकी तुम्हारा वो कैटेगरीज यू डू इट इन सम अदर चैप्टर्स हियर एनी टाइप ऑफ कंपनी इज कंपनी ऑलराइट Next, just for category wise, next is local authority. Your municipal corporation is a local authority. Gram Panchayat, local authority. Cantonment board, local authority. There are a lot of small local authorities we have. Sir, can a dog earn income? Can a dog earn income? Hello, I'm not asking about your boss, okay, but actual dog.
Yes.
Actual animal dog.
Yes.
Can they earn income?
Yes.
How?
Vodafone
dog. Then you are having entertainment dog. Okay. Then in some movies and all they act. Okay. Dog shows are there. All right. They, dog fashion shows are there. All right. Exhibition shows are there. You people sell dog. All right. So many things are there. So even animals can earn income. Are they person?
No.
Will they pay tax?
No.
Do they earn income?
Yes.
If they earn income, then they have to pay
tax.
If a dog can earn income, then dog can also pay tax. I'm not asking dog to get PAN card and Aadhaar card. Sorry. Alright. And then open bank account. But owner, obviously owner will do that. Alright. But still animal can earn income. Do gods earn income? Gods, Prabhu?
Yeah.
Ganpati Bappa?
Yes.
Sai Baba?
Yes.
Churches, Gurudwaras, do they earn income?
Yes.
If they can earn income, then I don't find Ganpati will hesitate to pay taxes.
Yes.
Sai Baba, he's sitting there in Shirdi and in, earning in crores. If some income tax go there, Baba, can you pay tax? Yes. Tatas to you. Okay, you take 30%, no problem. So God doesn't hesitate to pay taxes because they are also persons. Okay. No, sir, God is God, sir, Bhagwan, sir. How do you call them person? I'm not calling them person, okay? Income tax has covered that even in category of persons. If anything doesn't fall in this category, the last category is the juridical category. Juridical category means with a naked eye, it might not look like a person, but with a legal glass, 3D kind of glass. If you see it, it is a legal person, legal entity, which is earning couple of crores, couple of lakhs, and if they are earning income, they should pay taxes. Very simple, and therefore last category is artificial. They are artificial, no? Ganpati Bappa, Sai Baba, they are artificial, but juridical. Persons, okay, I call it other category, AJP. So what I have told you, what is total income and what is person. The definition of person is very important. This word is very important. It is inclusive because the last category is other category. Sir, PK came in this world. PK?
Yes.
Naked Amir Khan?
Yes.
All right, he came. Did he earn money?
Yes.
Will we allow him to go without paying taxes?
Yes.
But sir, he is alien. He is not like this. Okay, he is there in AJ. You bring anything new which does not exist in this category, that will be covered in AJP. Because the way they have drafted definition is
inclusive.
You understand? It's not exhaustive. They are not saying only this is a person. Somebody was asking cooperative society. Did I write cooperative society here? No. But somewhere it will get covered. Trust. Somewhere it will get covered. Because the definition is not exhaustive. Definition is inclusive. A person hai, ye person hai, ye person hai. और ये भी पर्सन है वो भी पर्सन है और कुछ नया आएगा वो भी पर्सन हो सकता है. दिस इज ओपन एंडेड डेफिनेशन. ओके, इंक्लूसिव डेफिनेशंस आर ऑलवेज ओपन एंडेड. दिस आर जस्ट इलस्ट्रेटिव लिस्ट ऑफ पर्सन्स. आर वी क्लियर अबाउट इट? सो यू राइट इट डाउन, देन वी विल कंटिन्यू.